Welcome to ISU Gen Chem Lab Tutorials. In this lesson, we'll cover how to use a volumetric pipette. We'll start with the parts of the pipette. At the very bottom is the tip, and at the very top of the pipette is the pipette mouth. Notice that every pipette is labeled with the volume that's calibrated to deliver, 10 milliliters for this pipette, but only when the pipette is filled exactly to its etch mark. It is always good practice to first clean and then rinse your pipette. To clean, insert the tip of the pipette into a small container of deionized water, and using a suction device, never your mouth, draw up enough deionized water to approximately half fill the pipette. Remove the suction device, cap the mouth of the pipette with your thumb or forefinger, and move the pipette into almost horizontal position. In this position, slowly rotate the pipette, allowing the deionized water to efficiently coat the insides of the pipette. After 5 or 10 seconds of doing this, place the pipette over a waste container, remove your thumb from the pipette mouth, and allow the deionized water to drain out. Repeat this cleaning step 2 additional times with more deionized water. Next, rinse your pipette with your solution in a process otherwise identical to the cleaning step. Repeat the rinsing step 2 additional times with more of your solution. The first of 2 common suction devices used in our labs to fill the pipette is the pipette pump. Turning its wheel will move the piston up, which will provide controlled suction of the liquid into the pipette. With the pipette pump snugly fitted to the mouth of the pipette and its tip immersed in a container of your solution, slowly turn the wheel, progressively filling the pipette until the liquid level is 1 or 2 above the etch mark, but well below the mouth of the pipette. Remove the pipette pump with one hand and immediately cover the mouth of the pipette with your thumb or forefinger of the other hand. Keeping pressure on the pipette mouth, raise the pipette so the etch mark is at eye level. Carefully control the pressure exerted by your thumb on the pipette mouth to slowly drop the level of liquid until its meniscus is exactly even with the etch mark. Next, hold the pipette over your destination container and release your thumb to allow gravity to drain the liquid. Finally, touch the pipette tip to the inside of the container to dispense of any half drops. The second common suction device is a 3-way pipette bulb. Operation of this bulb requires the use of 3 pinch valves labeled A, S, and E. The A valve is to allow air to escape the bulb when the bulb is squeezed. Pinching the S valve provides suction of the liquid into the pipette and consequently reinflates the bulb. Finally, pinching the E valve empties the liquid out of the pipette in a controlled fashion. First, pinch the A valve while simultaneously squeezing the bulb. After the bulb is fully squeezed, release the A valve and affix the bulb to the mouth of the pipette. Second, with the tip of the pipette immersed in a container of your solution, pinch the S valve to draw liquid into the pipette until the liquid level is 1 to 2 inches above the etch mark, but well below the mouth of the pipette. Raise the pipette so the etch mark is at eye level, and use the E valve to carefully drain the liquid until its meniscus is aligned with the etch mark. Finally, hold the pipette over the destination container and remove the pipette bulb to allow gravity to drain the liquid. Lastly, touch the pipette tip to the inside wall of the destination container. When finished, clean the pipette with 2 or 3 volumes of deionized water as before.